Mr. Speaker, I want to thank the gentleman from Arizona for his work on this issue and for introducing this important bill. Mr. Speaker, it's undeniable that we have a much better understanding today of life inside the womb than we did at the time of the passage of Roe v. Wade. My colleagues on the other side of the aisle express a commitment to science in all cases, except where it matters most, in those cases that involve the preservation of human life. They don't want to talk about babies. They don't want to talk about the horrific procedures that we're dealing with today, and we have to. It's our obligation to. Mr. Speaker, our country has banned partial birth abortion in a decision that was upheld by the Supreme Court. And I would just urge my colleagues to look at the decision in that opinion, Gonzales v. Carhart, the decision written by Justice Kennedy, talking in specific, quoting a nurse, talking about the reaction of a 26-week-old baby who was the victim of partial birth abortion, what their reaction, the physical reaction, as the mother of little babies, reading that, the description of what happens to a baby when they're killed, of watching their hands expand and then contract, as any mother of a newborn infant has watched many, many times, is truly horrific. And I think as a society, Mr. Speaker, we have to be willing to face the exact nature of what it is we're talking about. We have an obligation as elected representatives, Mr. Speaker, to protect the lives of these unborn babies. This legislation would do that. We have a moral obligation, and it is our job, and it is the interest of the state to make sure, Mr. Speaker, that we do everything possible to protect life. In this case, Mr. Speaker, we're talking about a bill that would protect babies at moments when we know they can feel pain in the womb. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, I urge the adoption of both the rule and of H.R. 36 so that we can continue to protect and save lives.